What's happening, people? Back with another Icon review, and today we're looking at Monsieur Laurent Blanc. Now, this is the first centre back that I'm reviewing on this channel. We got Icon Prime Moments Laurent Blanc, obviously the French World Cup winner, very dominant defender. Let's take a look at his card. 6'4", medium high work rate, right footed, 2-star skill moves, 3-star weak foot. Played 23 games with him so far, 2 goals scored. He is out on SBC at the moment and it is very dirt cheap. I believe there's only an 87 and an 85 squad that you need to put in. The rest is very straightforward. So very cheap SBC out. If you're looking to do it, go ahead and grab it. You can grab yourself a bargain Icon Moments player. I replaced him with Ronald Koeman, who was in my squad for a long time, so we'll compare how he does compared to Koeman. Koeman was a very good underrated Icon in my team, played loads of matches. So let's take a look at the Blanc card. As you can see, everything's green. 83 pace, 71 shooting, 72 passing, 79 dribbling, 95 defending, 88 physical. Now, the ones we care about is the defending, physical and the pace, which are very impressive. Interceptions 93, heading accuracy 89, defending awareness 96, standing tackle 97, slide tackle 91, 78 jumping, 91 stamina, 87 strength, 90 aggression, and then pace we're looking at 82 acceleration and 84 sprint speed. Now, 83 pace is very impressive for a defender. That's the most important one, because you want fast defenders at the back. You want him to catch players in case you get run past, but defending stats are impressive. As you can see, everything's green as well. So stats wise, this is a solid, very solid looking card. Other things to look at: ball control 88, which is really good, 90 composure, which always helps. Player traits, he's got team player. Let's take a quick look at his Icon profile. Laurent Blanc may have missed the 1998 World Cup final, but he was still a huge part of France's success in the competition, as he scored the first ever golden goal in World Cup history in the round of 16. During 0-0 with Paraguay and with the game seemingly heading for penalties, France was desperate for the winning goal and flooded the box. Defender Blanc, in the perfect poacher's position, got on the end of a knockdown and calmly hit a low first time shot into the back of the net. Now guys, he's one of the players which was, you know, seemingly before my time. Don't really remember much about watching him, but I've heard about him. So club career, Montpellier, 251 appearances, 77 goals. Wow, he's played for Napoli in the past, Saint Etienne, FC Barcelona, 38 appearances, 1 goal. Obviously, Olympic Marseille, 73 appearances, 15 goals. Inter, 83 appearances, 6 goals. Manchester United, 75 appearances, 4 goals. Played for a lot of big clubs in his time. And obviously, national career, France, 97 appearances, 16 goals. As you can see, very important player. He's very dominant sort of presence. I believe he's captained a lot of his clubs and throughout his career as well. So this is how we're going to play him. We're going to play him next to headliners Van Dijk. We've got Klaus to the right, which is perfect. Kim as well. French. We've got Fofana in the middle, who as well is a French connection. Obviously Fofana's impressive. We're going to play him in a 4-5-1 formation. Let's see how we get on in game. So obviously, first game, let's test out the penalty stats. His penalty stats are 98, so let's put him to the test. And simple enough, goal. Keeper got sent, not bad. Obviously Koeman was more of a goal scoring defender, to be honest. Let's go, first game, Laurent Blanc in defense up against Maradona. Can he take him? Gives it to Petit. Oh, Blanc, what a tackle. First time, as soon as he turned. He was there like a shadow. Oh, and Blanc again. Gets the ball. Good interception. Let's go. Gives the ball to Klaus. Down the wing. Oh, Salah gets tackled. Here we go. Maradona. Oh, fouled. Diaby. Oh, what a block by Blanc. Fantastic block. Fofana has the ball. Gives it to Maradona. That Maradona is a pain. And this Payet. Oh, no match for Blanc. Takes the ball off him. Klaus gives it to Maradona. Oh, ooh, good tackle by Blanc initially. Then obviously the ricochet took the ball off him. Oh, lost the ball. Payet. Ah, oh, Blanc just missed out on the tackle there. Oh, what a recovery. Ref, that is not a foul. What a challenge. He got the ball clean there. As you can see, 91 slide tackling he's got. In the air, Laurent Blanc. Oh, good win. He's very dominant in the air. As you can see, he really owns the box. Henry against Laurent Blanc. Let's see, can he take him? Yes, he can, easily. Oh, not once, but twice. Well done. Salah skips past players. Can we get a goal out of this attack? Maybe not. There we go, Laurent Blanc on the wing. Get off the ball. He's standing tackle, 91 standing tackle. It really shows. Oh, I hate players that do this. Not against Blanc. Get off the ball. So as if you've been playing FIFA for a long time, you know a lot of people do that twist and turn. Not against Laurent Blanc. He will take the ball off them. Let's go. Blanc against Guri. Easy, easy. As they get off the ball. Let's see what his delivery is like. Blanc on the ball, composed. Gets the ball off to Klaus. Who's off on his bike. Can we get a goal here? Oh, what a chance. Oh, what a goal. That all came from the back. What a build-up from goal kick. Laurent Blanc started that move. There we go again. In the air, Blanc. Dominant. Dominant display again. Oh, look at that. Interception. He was out of position there, but he still got back, made the interception. Brilliant play. Oh, he's off. They're attacking. Butragueño gives it to Hullet, but not if Blanc can help it. Again, very dominant in the air, very dominant on the floor too. The only sort of weakness is the pace. If it's very hard to get past him, but once you're past him, as you can see there, look. But he's got the physical strength to get back. What a tackle, Blanc. In the air again, dominant in the air. Gets to the corner. And again, sweeps up at the back. Plays it out to Cancelo. Brilliant card. Brilliant defender. Here we go. Mikel Antonio against Blanc. Gets the ball. You're not getting past him. Brilliant play. There we go, in the air again. Defending corners. Blanc wins it. Gives it to R9. R9's off. Gives it to Son. He's got tons of space. He goes R9 for support. Finds him. Henry's making that run. Can he ding the keeper? Oh, what a goal! That is what you call counter-attacking football, guys. Take notes, that is how you counter-attack. I don't know actually know how he got to that before the keeper came out. That was brilliant, Henry. There we go. Laurent Blanc gets to the ball again. As you can see, corners are not a problem for him. He's always there to win it. Oh, Blanc's there. Reflexes, gives it to Klaus. Gives it to Salah. Who gives it to Ronaldo on the wing. Can we get a goal here? It's 3-on-1, essentially. And R9 gets the finish again. Started from Klaus at the back. Blanc at the back. Oh, what a tackle. What a tackle. I'm sure that was a foul, but he got away with it. Laurent Blanc. Oh, two interceptions in a row. Composure, and it just starts the attack. Can we score from this? Oh, now that was purely from Laurent Blanc. He gets all the credit. He made two interceptions in a row, played it down the wing, and then we went ahead to score. Brilliant play. So, we've had a look at the card in-game. Very impressive. The card is very good in-game. He's a very dominant defender. He dominates his box. He's great at tackling, great at sliding. The only issue I found that even though he's got 83 pace, his body type is quite stocky. It's very hard to get back. If a player runs past you, you know, the likes of Mbappe, R9, Maradona, if a player gets past you, it's very hard to catch them, because as he's running back, he feels very slow, very stiff. That's because of the stocky body type, maybe. But I find it very hard to get back. Then again, it is very hard for a player to get past him in the first place. He is a very solid, dominating defender. Is, you know, I would say maybe 7 times out of 10 he will get the ball. So it's very hard to get past him. But if you do get past him, you need faster players around him. You need faster wing backs, faster center back partner to get back and save him, because it is very hard to play catch up. Nevertheless, it's a very good card. As you saw from the gameplay, he's a brilliant card, brilliant defender. He was tackling the likes of Maradona, Mbappe, you know, of Henri. Very good players were going up against him and struggling. It's like I said, rating wise, I would probably give it a solid 8 out of 10, only because he took over from Koeman. Even though his rating's higher than mid Koeman, I just found Koeman a bit more, he just felt a bit much lighter, much quicker than Koeman. And obviously Koeman's free kick wise, you know, Koeman was really good. So even the value for money, SBC is very cheap. For the price that you're getting him for, he's definitely worth it. He's 100% worth it. Very fun to play with. He's a World Cup winner, guys. This is a World Cup winning defender. So his stats speak for him. So he plays for very big clubs. He's French as well. You can link him with a lot of players. You can link him with League One players. You can link him with anyone that's French. Obviously, he's an icon. For the price that you're getting him at, it's a solid card. I would say 100% do the SBC. And if you like this video, if you like FIFA, if you like gaming in general, please like, comment, subscribe. I drop videos every week. Let me know if there's any icons or cards in particular you want me to review, and I will take a look. And thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.